Hello everyone, I am Sudatta. I'll be taking consumer laws and RTI in continuation with the previous videos that I am offering. So again, I'll start with the definition of the consumer to clarify on the previous video that what under the definition of Consumer Protection Act, what are the things that are included, how a consumer need to be paid under relating to the consideration, what is the beneficiary of services and the services. So I'll start with the commercial purpose, which is very important. Now, commercial purpose, now on the concept of commercial purpose, many of the consumer complaints are been denied, saying that this services or this defect includes commercial services, for which most of the complaints are denied in the consumer forums. So what we understand by a commercial purpose, how the court should decide that it is for a commercial purpose and this is for a self-employment, where you are purchasing a good or you are purchasing a community for your own livelihood. So to understand commercial purpose, now again, commercial purpose means when you are saying it is for a commercial purpose, it means that it is for commerce where you want a profit out of it. Now profit, again, it is differentiated. The profit maybe it is for your own livelihood or for a business purpose to make more. So we'll make it understand with two case studies. One is Lakshmi Engineering Works versus PSG Industries, AIR 1995, Supreme Court 1428. Now, in this case, what happened? I'm not discussing the facts. I'm directly going what Supreme Court has decided. Now, Supreme Court has said how you will decide that it is for a commercial purpose. One is where the commercial business should have a nexus with the close and direct nexus with the commercial activity. Now, on the basis, again, the same term, I'm repeating the facts and circumstances. Now, again, the court will decide whatever earnings, that is annually or monthly or quarterly, whatever the person is earning, that is only for his livelihood. Again, it depends upon the facts, how they will decide the livelihood of a person in a family, how many persons are there, what is the maximum number of, income you want to leave his livelihood. Again, the court will decide on the facts to consider that whether it is considered for a commercial purpose or not. Now, it depends upon, that has to be a close and direct nexus with the commercial business. Then only the court can decide whether it is for a commercial purpose or not. For example, suppose I'll give you an example that in a Xerox machine. Now, usually in a family, a person wants 15 to 20,000 to leave his livelihood. Now, if that person is earning 2 lakhs or 3 lakhs rupees from that company, then that cannot be considered for a livelihood or self-employment. That will be considered. Now, for example, in one, the person is having 10 Xerox machines or 50 Xerox machines. So that cannot be used for self-employment. It will directly considered as a commercial purpose. Again, I'll give you another case study of Chilkuri Others versus ESSV Construction 2012, Volume 3, CPG, stands for Consumer Protection Journals, 315, where it says when a person is purchasing a flat. Now, if a person is purchasing one flat, that can be considered and that will be considered as a livelihood, or that can be considered, that will come under the definition of consumer. If, for example, any dispute is arising. But if the person is purchasing 10 flats in the same construction from the same construction company, he cannot be considered as a consumer. Definitely, the person will be coming under, the person is using the property for commercial purpose. So there we differentiate who is a consumer, who can file a consumer application and who can't file a consumer application if the person is doing resale of the goods and services or doing it for a commercial purpose. So I think you have understood what is the definition of who is a consumer and what is the purpose of consumer commercial purpose. Then we'll come to the complaint. Who can file a complaint? Now, under Section 21B of Consumer Protection Act, who can file a complaint, which is very important. A business person cannot file a consumer complaint. It has been categorized under 5 heads. One is a consumer can file a complaint. Any voluntary association who is registered under Companies Act 2013, a state government and central government can file a consumer complaint. one or more consumer having same interest. For example, a group of persons are there who have used a product which is having the same defect, and they have a same cause or same interest or same amount of compensation. 10 or 15 persons are asking for. So a group of person having the same interest can file a consumer complaint before the consumer forum. And last is the legal heir. In case of the death of the person, the legal heir can file a consumer complainant. So these are the five categories of person who are called as the complainant under Consumer Protection Act 1986. Then we'll come to the complaint. Now what is a complaint? Now every complaint is not considered as a consumer complaint. So there are certain definitions, or you can say certain problems that has already cited under the Consumer Protection Act, where you can allege that this is a consumer complaint. So your complaint has to be the coming under the definition of complaint. Now what type of complaint? If there is a defect in good, if there is a deficiency in services, medical negligence cases, food adulteration, poor quality of goods and services, if the price of the commodity is more than the MRP price, that complaint petition has to contain this type of offenses, so that can be filed before the consumer forum, which is there in section 2 subsection 1c. 2(1)(c) it is described as under the Consumer Protection Act what is a complaint. Then we'll come to a consumer dispute, the last important provision under the Consumer Protection Act is the consumer dispute. Now for example, if you don't have a dispute, then the consumer forum will not accept your application. Now you should have a consumer dispute. Now what is a consumer dispute? Now for example, a person has filed an allegation and the manufacturer is accepting that, then that cannot be considered as a consumer dispute. Now when a consumer dispute arises, now consumer dispute has been mentioned, or it has been defined under section 2(1)(e), where it says if the manufacturer or the service provider is alleging that he or she has not done any dispute, or he has not provided any poor quality, he is denying his allegation on the complaint, then only a consumer dispute arises, where the relief or compensation is provided. Otherwise, if the consumer dispute doesn't arise, then no question of compensation or relief or replacement of the product or services is provided. So this is all about the important provisions before we know the defect in services and deficiency in goods. Then we'll discuss about the pecuniary jurisdiction of the four forums and the role of consumer councils in the next video. Thank you.